Computer science is very young science. It's really only existed for 50 or 60 years, and most advances are driven by the technology, because things that are theoretically possible but not practically possible one day may become practically possible within a few years. So memory sizes, clock speeds, these things everybody is aware of, enable us to do far more on a mobile phone than I would have been able to do with my research computers when I was doing my PhD. Students here are doing all kinds of things. We have people working at the interface between biology and computer science, and those students are helping to find out how human proteins interact with each other. It's kind of the stage after the Human Genome Project. We have people that are interested in data analytics, so they're the kinds of people who are working out consumer behavior, what drives consumer behavior. We have people that are interested in security, and we have people that are interested in basic algorithms. And in a way, these folk are probing the very foundations of what computers can do quickly, and they develop ideas and algorithms that the rest of us can use for more applications-oriented research. So industry input is managed through a bunch of people that we call our industrial advisory board, and they come along a couple of times a year to see what we're doing. We have companies of all sizes, from multinationals down to small consultancies with just two or three people in them. And if you look around the program, you'll find many areas where their input has changed what we teach, but mostly in software engineering and in the projects. It's the projects in particular where students get a chance to really show what they're capable of in a single piece of work that they've designed and implemented. And it becomes a showcase for their talents, a showcase for everything they've learned in their 3 or perhaps 4 years with us over the years.